Our next class speaker is a biological researcher who has sought to answer fundamental questions about the integration of endocrine and brain functions. The daughter of a doctor and nurse, immigrants from China, she spent many childhood weekends in her father's lab. Immersed in science from an early age, she has said, "I was always interested in biology. I can't remember a time when I wasn't." Today, she has gone from examining the complex microcosm of the brain to the equally complex but very different microcosm of a major public research university. She is a highly respected administrator and the first Asian American woman to lead a major American research university. She advises her students to, quote, observe and learn from people who exemplify what you aspire to be. And I might add, listening and learning is not just something she advises her students to do, but a principle she practices herself. Today, we're here to follow her lead, and it is my pleasure to welcome to the podium the speaker for Class 5, the Chancellor of the University of Illinois at Urbana-Champaign, Phyllis Wise.
Thank you, John. It is particularly wonderful to be introduced by one of my faculty and one of my wonderful scientific colleagues. It's a great honor to be here this afternoon, just the past few days being able to rub shoulders with such an incredible group of people, accomplished, generous, giving back to society the way the American Academy is, has been a real privilege. It is humbling and exhilarating to be among such distinguished inductees today and to be part of an organization that really its founding is at the time of the founding of our country. As the chancellor of a major research university, my job is to blend the idealism of 43,000 students with the practicality of running a $1 billion enterprise with over 2,500 faculty and over 8,000 employees. An institution like the University of Illinois has no shortage of idealism. Every fall, we welcome about 7,000 students who leave their communities and their families to join us in the middle of cornfields and join 36,000 other students. They come to us from all over. They come to us predominantly from Illinois, but from every state in the nation and over 100 countries around the world with incredibly different backgrounds to this cauldron of activity that we call the University of Illinois, where they spend between 4 and 5 years and then go out to be leaders around the globe. It is our privilege to really be working with these students, teaching them and learning from them during these very formative years of their lives. When I think about the students who grace our campus, I think about Daniel Burnham, one of the great architects in the world from Chicago, who said, "Make no little plans. They have no magic that stir the blood of men." So when I think about the years that the students will spend with us, I think about the amount of change that will occur just during that 4 to 6 years. When I think about Thomas Friedman and the book that he wrote, The World is Flat, and then just 6 years later wrote another book called That Used to Be, he says that when he wrote the first book, Facebook didn't exist. Tweeting was something birds did. 4G was a parking space. The cloud was what was in the sky. LinkedIn was a prison. And apps were what you did when you wanted to go to college. But you know, when I think about what our mission is, what our function is, it is in fact to combine that idealism with practicality. And despite the rapid pace of change, in fact, which is, if anything, getting more rapid, the mission of academic leaders and faculty will remain steadfastly the same. It is, in fact, to extend the boundaries of the minds of our students, extend the boundaries of the faculty so that they can do what they really must do. But that's where practicality comes into play. As the leader of a public research intensive university with an eroding support from the state, with innovations in learning that are revolutionary, with rising tuition that is hitting all of us who really wish to provide excellence and access for our students. This is an incredible time in higher education. Over the last couple of years, we have had a visioning exercise at the University of Illinois where I asked two questions. What are society's greatest challenges going to be 20 to 50 years from now? And what is the role of a major public research university? And we gathered information from many, many people. Our faculty, our staff, our students, the community leaders in Urbana-Champaign and in Chicago, and many of our alums. And we came up with six emerging themes, such as energy and the environment, health and wellness, cultural understanding. These are ambitious plans that will frame what we will be doing over the next several years in terms of how we recruit new faculty, how we develop new courses. Are we ambitious? Yes, we are. But I hearken back to what Daniel Burnham said, plan no small ideas. But we are not alone in our ambition. When I think about universities, we all share the same kind of ambition. That is, our great universities are the envy of the world. That is what we are here for. I believe that higher education's impact in civilization has been to develop the talent of predominantly young people. It has fueled the Industrial Revolution. It has fueled the knowledge economy. And today, it also provides social mobility to people who would otherwise never dream to be able to be where they are. Higher education, particularly at research universities, have literally transformed agriculture, medicine, communications, energy, our study of the environment, and transportation. And if we plan carefully, they will continue to play that role. I strongly believe that educators and academic leaders, as we play the role in those positions, we owe the people of this nation and this world to provide the most transformative experiences that we possibly can to their daughters and their sons, while we also meet the challenges of society to provide basic discoveries all the way to applications to make the world a better place. Thank you.